So we're going to factor completely 5y squared plus 40y plus 75. Now it looks like we have three terms here, which means we have a trinomial. So in order to factor trinomials, there's a couple of different methods you can take. So we're going to go over three different methods to solve this problem. You can choose whichever method you'd like as long as you get the right answer. So the first method we're going to try is the grouping method. Second method we're going to try is the trial and error method. And the third method we're going to try is the Berry method. Before we start with any method, the first thing I'm going to do is try and take out a GCF from this trinomial. That way we can work with smaller numbers. So in 5y squared plus 40y plus 75, first of all, they're all divisible by 5, so I'm going to go ahead and take out a 5. So once I take out a 5, I'm left with y squared plus 8y plus 15. So let's start with the grouping method. Now, in the grouping method, you need to have four terms in order to do this method. And here we only have three. But there is a way where we can expand the expression to make it four terms completely legally. So I'm going to go ahead and write down my expression again. 5 times y squared plus 8y plus 15. Now, the grouping method is also called the AC method, and it is because to start off, you're going to multiply your A and your C, which here, my A is 1 and my C is 15, so my A times my C is 15. Now, I'm going to find two numbers that multiply to make 15, but that also add to make the middle term, or my B, which is 8. Now, I'm referring this back to ax squared plus bx plus c. So my a here is 1, my b is 8, and my c is 15. Okay, so the factors of 15 are 1 and 15, 3 and 5, and I believe that's about it. So the numbers that multiply to make 15 that also add to make 8 are 3 and 5. So what we're going to do with 3 and 5 is plug those into our middle term instead of this 8. So that's going to look like this. 5 times y squared plus 3y plus 5y plus 15. Because 8y is the same thing as 3 and 5. But now we have 4 terms, and we can go ahead and factor by grouping this way. So in factoring by grouping, you're taking out the GCF of the first two terms and then the GCF of the next two terms. Now, because this 5 is here, just be careful. Just keep bringing it down. Don't forget about it. So my GCF of the first two terms is just y, and that's going to leave me with y plus 3. And now my GCF of my next two terms is 5, and that's going to leave me with y plus 3. Now my GCF of my entire expression in here is y plus 3, and that's going to leave me with y and then plus 5. And then I'm going to bring down my 5 on the outside here. My factors for this expression are 5, y plus 3, and y plus 5. So now let's try the trial and error method. So with the trial and error method, I'm going to rewrite my problem. So 5 times y squared plus 8y plus 15. Now, since we have a trinomial, if a trinomial can be factored, it can always be factored into two binomials. So since here we have y squared, I'm going to separate that into y and y. Okay? And I'm going to bring down my 5 here as well. Now here's where the estimating or the guessing takes place. So we're going to try to guess which two factors multiply to make 15 and add to make 8. So this is kind of similar to the grouping method here. So this works much easier when the coefficient here in the first term is just 1, like what we have here, because we're basically just asking what two numbers multiply to make 15 and add to make 8. If you had a different value here that wasn't 1, you would multiply this by 15, and then you would find two factors that multiply to equal that number that add to equal 8. Same thing we did here with the grouping. Okay, so the factors of 15 are 1 and 15 and 3 and 5. So we're going to go ahead and guess which ones are going to also add up to make 8 and try and see if we can put those in the correct bubbles. Now, for this problem, it's very easy to see that it's going to be 3 and 5 because 3 plus 5 equals 8. But if you had, for example, like a negative here or a larger number, then you would have to guess more often which factors would work. But here we're going to see that when we put 3 here and 5 here, it doesn't matter the placement because they're both positive. And now to check if this works, what we're going to do is we're going to multiply 3 times y, which is going to give us 3y, and y times 5, which is going to give us 5y. And now we're going to add these two together, which gives us 8y, which is what we have here. So that's the checking your estimate or checking your guess portion of the trial and error method. So because that works, we're kind of all set. We got our factors, which are 5 times y plus 3 times y plus 5. So let's try the Berry method. Now in the Berry method, we're going to go over a few like shortcuts and little tricks you can do to go ahead and factor a trinomial. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is write down our expression. 5 times y squared plus 8y plus 15. Okay, now if a trinomial can be factored, it'll always factor into two binomials. So I'm going to go ahead and bring down my 5 here out in front. Now, because this is y squared and it's a coefficient of 1 over here, I'm going to put y and y. Okay, now we're going to look at the factors of 15. So the factors of 15 are 1 and 15 and 3 and 5. Now we're going to look for two numbers. Now, because the 15 is positive, we're looking for two numbers that add to equal 8. Now we're not looking at this positive sign yet. We're just looking at the value of 8. Okay? So two factors of 15 that add to equal 8. If this was a subtraction sign, then it would be two factors that have a difference of 8. Okay, so those factors are going to be 3 and 5. Now, we're going to place the highest value in the first bubble and the other value in the second bubble. Now we're going to look at this positive sign, and we're going to bring this positive sign down here. And now to figure out which sign is here, we're going to ask ourselves, what does this positive sign have to multiply to create an answer that is also positive? Because that's what we have here. This is a question mark, by the way. Okay, so let's repeat that. So what does this sign have to multiply to create a positive sign? Well, the answer is another positive, because a positive times a positive makes a positive. Okay, so there is our answer. 5 times y plus 5 times y plus 3. And that is how you get the same answer using three different methods.